Hey everybody out there, just wanted to introduce myself. My name's Wayne Craig and this is my beautiful bride, Jamie. Steve McCool asked that maybe we might share a few minutes with you guys about our recent trials with dealing with COVID and how it affected our family. So I'll let Jamie go first and talk about her and Kelsey.
So I got sick first and then a few days later my daughter got sick. The symptoms for me early were horrible body aches, low-grade fever, and cough. After about 5 days, those symptoms subsided, but really the weakness was bad for about 9 more days. And the same with our daughter as well.
Yeah, so after, I think it was about 5 or 6 days after Jamie came down with the symptoms, that's when I got sick. I myself personally have a weakened immune system, so it kind of attacked me pretty bad. For about the first 2 weeks, I don't remember a whole lot. It was basically just in bed and then occasionally being able to waddle to the bathroom, and that was about it. That was my life for about 2 weeks. I did go to the ER 3 different times. That's a pretty lonely and pretty scary thing to do. You know, when you go to the ER, and maybe as in the future for you prayer warriors out there, be thinking about these family members that have to do this. You get dropped off at the front door. Your family members have to leave and go home, and you get escorted back to an isolation room. And unless the doctors or nurses actually need to do any kind of physical, you know, touch you or do anything on you physically, you are communicated through a speaker or the doorway. So it's a pretty rough and lonely experience. And so, but by the grace of God and your guys' prayers, I was always healthy enough, just right at that borderline to where I got released each day and didn't get sent to the ICU. So I'm so thankful for that.
His oxygen levels would drop below where they wanted him to be, so I'd take him to the emergency room, and after 3 or 4 hours, his oxygen level would come back up high enough to send him home. It was very scary for me dropping him off and not being able to stay with him. I had to leave, cry my way home.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a rough bug. There's no doubt about it. You know, I remember laying on the bed in the emergency room and just thinking, okay, God, you know, I know this is a trial, and I know you have a plan for me, and I just had to have faith that everything was in your control and just suffer through it and fight my way through it. And I know my story and my case is not the same as everybody. There were others that were submitted to the ICU that had to get on ventilators, and but you know, God clearly, with the grace of His love, sent me home to where my girls could doctor me and take care of me, and which I'm so thankful for. But
I don't think you'll eat soup or drink tea for a long time.
No, I'm burned out on tea and soup. Well, anyways, I'll close. The one thing I do want to share with you, one of the verses that I will often lean on in my life, and not just through this, but many, many things. It seems like any time we're going through a trial or something, is Philippians 4. And in chapter 4, it says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, and with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus." So, can't think of a better way to end this video but praying. So if you would join me in a prayer real quick, we'll just lay this stuff at God's feet and ask for His guidance. So pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I just thank You. Lord, we praise You. Lord, we love You. Lord, we're so thankful that we have You here with us to guide us, calm our hearts. So Lord, tonight I'd like to lift up to You all those families that are still struggling with COVID. the family members outside the hospital and the family members inside the hospital. It's so difficult to be able to have to stay home while your loved ones lay in the hospital. So Lord, we just want to lift up them to you. Lord, we want to pray for all the our leaders in our country. Lord, pray that they have the wisdom and the common sense on how to get everybody back to work again. And Lord, we just pray for all the doctors and the nurses. And Lord, we just thank you for all of this. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. I'd also like to say a big shout out to all the prayer warriors out there. You know, as I was really laying there suffering in bed, Jamie would bring the phone to me and emails and texts and Facebook from family members and friends in probably 16, 17 different states in America and in all of our church family and our dear friends in Uganda with NHU and NHUM both. You know, I remember getting Jay Dangers reaching out to me, and I was just blown away that so many people were praying for us. And I know it was you prayer warriors out there that were taking the time to pray for people like me that really got me through and kept me out of that ICU and kept me off the ventilator. So I just want to say a special thank you to all you.
Very humbling.
Yeah, it was really humbling. I mean, it really was. I just had no idea there were so many people out there praying for us. All of our church family here in Dickinson, North Dakota, with EBC. Just absolutely amazing. So thank you again from the bottom of our hearts, and God bless.